Respected chairpersons, very good afternoon to all of you. Trabectomy is still considered the gold standard for medically uncontrolled glaucoma. These are the basic surgical steps performed at the time of a standard trabectomy. It's always a good practice to arrange the various instruments in sequence before the start of the surgery. Coming to the video, a superior rectus traction suture is taken. It is always a good habit to measure the dimensions of the conjunctival flap. A 5 to 6 millimeter of conjunctival flap is good enough. Phonics-based flaps are preferred these days mainly because of the scleral exposure and controlled surgery they afford. Dissect backwards with Westcott scissors to make a pocket of approximately 10 to 15 millimeters posteriorly and wide for the anti-metabolite sponges. Cautery should be just adequate. Extensive and excessive cautery should be avoided. Polyvinyl alcohol sponges soaked in mitomycin C are placed under the conjunctival flap as posteriorly as possible to enhance the posterior flow of aqueous. After 2 to 15 minutes, the sponges are removed carefully. After removal of the sponges, the treated area should be thoroughly and copiously irrigated with at least 20 ml of balanced salt solution. A scleral cap size of 4 by 4 millimeter or 4 by 3 millimeter is good enough. The triangular scleral flap margins are demarcated using a number 11 blade. The scleral flap is dissected using a 15 number blade. The dissection should be kept at half of scleral thickness. Each scleral incision is made in one continuous movement. Depending upon the case and surgeon's preference, scleral flap sutures can be pre-placed. Here, a releasable suture is being applied. Paracentesis is done. Anterior chamber is entered with a number 11 blade. Kelly's desmoid membrane punch is used for sclerostomy. Iridotomy should be made relatively broad at the base but short in length. After iridotomy, the sclerostomy site is washed and balanced with salt solution. The pre-placed suture is being applied at the apex of the scleral flap. Having placed the suture, the need for further sutures can be assessed by inflating the eye through the paracentesis and observing the amount of aqueous flow through the flap. There, a second rigorous suture is being applied to one side of the triangular scleral flap. There are various techniques of applying rigorous sutures. This is one of the techniques. A third suture, which is an interrupted one, is being applied to the other side of the scleral flap. The knot is buried in the scleral bed. The bridle suture is removed. For a phonics-based conjunctival flap, two wing sutures are used to attach the conjunctiva to the limbus. It is important to take a firm bite in the episcleria close to the cornea. After closure of the conjunctival flap, the anterior chamber is deepened by injecting balanced salt solution through the paracentesis. Finally, antibiotic eye drops are instilled and the eye is closed. To conclude, I would like to say that each and every surgical step of trabectomy is important and should be done meticulously to achieve the desired outcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Shiraz. It was a wonderful presentation, and I hope if the beginners and junior residents, they are listening to it, they would have benefited from it definitely. So, first of all, I would thank you for a nice presentation, and I would ask Dr. Aditya, sir, if he can share his experiences, that what he went through while teaching all of us, because he has been a trainer and an immense help to us when we were doing our fellowships. Dr. Aditya, sir, over to you.
Yeah. Excellent video, Sajay sir, Dr. Shiraz. So like it has been shown, each step has to be done very meticulously, like we have seen in the video. And one of the main things which I feel that initially when we do cataract, the care for the conjunctiva, which is required many a times when we do a conjunctival peritomy in a cataract, we are not so concerned. But in this, we have to be extra careful, taking care to hold it properly and always using a colibri forceps or non-tooth forceps. That is very critical because a conjunctival tear, many a times it occurs, many a times I have also seen end of surgery, everything went well, then there is a conjunctival tear. Then we are caught with it and this will be discussed subsequently. So that is one thing which is very important, I feel. And then when we do the dissection of the scleral bed, one point I feel is we should have a dry bed, because if it is wet, it's very difficult to gauge the thickness. And that is one thing I thought. And one more important thing is like when we use the MMC sponges, we have to make sure that we take them out properly. Sometimes some sponges tend to break, and we have to make sure that they don't break when we cut them. So these are some of the things. And each step has to be done very meticulously, closure. And one thing is very important, that when we are doing the sclerostomy, we should not let the AC be shallow for a long time, specifically in cases which have angle closure glaucoma and all, which can lead to other problems. But a very excellent surgery we have seen now.
Thank you, sir. Shikha ma'am, what would your experiences about teaching and training the beginners and the residents, and especially the fellows, when they are being precise about the glaucoma surgeries? So any tips for the people who are learning the surgeries or still doing but still facing some difficulties in the surgery?
Okay, very excellent video presentation and nice points by Aditya. Same things to reiterate, you have to be very careful that no, the field is dry. When you're putting mitomycin C, count the sponges and make sure you do a good posterior dissection and keep the sponges a little posterior, not towards the limbar side, and wash it thoroughly so that you have a good diffuse posterior bleb and not towards the limbar side. And try to keep the anterior chamber well formed throughout. And the sutures, you can pre-place the sutures, especially you can take the... even I prefer the triangular flap, some prefer rectangular flap. So for my this thing, I would always pre-place the suture, especially the basal, two basal ones, before we take out the punch. So that no, once you, it is done, you can immediately suture, and then your chamber will not be flat for too long.
Thank you, ma'am. Adit, sir, one more question. What is your take about making a stoma? That's what we, what ma'am was saying about the punch. Do we have to leave a specific area which is going to be covered along with the flap alongside of both the sides of the punch?
That's a very good point. See, then you will see when you look at various surgeries, various surgeons, some surgeons make a huge, very large stoma. Some people make a very small stoma. But the most important thing is at least to have half mm coverage between the top of the scleral flap and the edge of the stoma. That is very important. Then only you get the guarded filtration. If it is eccentric, then you will have overflow. That is very important. Because it's always easier to maintain. If you have less flow, it's something you can handle. But if you have overflowing and a shallow AC, that's more.